पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रै कपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। ओम नमो भगवते वेंकटेशाय। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड ब्लेसिंग्स टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वरा भक्ति चैनल। हरि ओम, नमस्कार। श्रीमद् भगवद गीता फर्स्ट चैप्टर वर्स नंबर 28। अर्जुन उवाच दृष्ट्वे मम स्वजनम कृष्ण युयुत्सुम समवस्थितम सीदन्ति मम गात्राणि मुखम च परिशुष्यति। एज वी सॉ इन द लास्ट सेशन, अर्जुन रिक्वेस्टेड कृष्ण टू टेक हिज चैरियट एंड प्लेस इन बिटवीन बोथ आर्मीज। जस्ट ही वॉन्टेड टू सी दैट with whom that he wants to fight. When Shri Krishna took his chariot and placed right in front of Drona and Bhishmacharya, then this Arjuna, so when he looked at them, his mind was very shocked. And suddenly, you know, his mind and buddhi was working. This is not a marriage ceremony. This is not the festival. This is not the puja time. This is not the occasion of the family gathering. What these people are doing here? Just I would like to see to energize my energy. But all these relatives in the form of enemies. Then his mind is not able to think further. He says, Imam yuyutsum samavasthitam svajanam drishtva mama gatrani sidanti. O Krishna, by seeing these people who are nothing but relatives in the form of enemy, or in the place of enemy, my body it loses its energy. I become tired. Mukham cha parichushyati. My mouth goes dry. I'm not able to speak. Then the next words also continues here. वेपथुश्च शरीरे मे रोमहर्षश्च जायते गांडीवं स्रंसते हस्तात् त्वच्चैव परिदह्यते। शरीरे मे शरीरे रोमहर्षश्च वेपथुश्च जायते। माय बॉडी इज ट्रेम्बलिंग एंड माय हेयर्स ऑन द बॉडी इज स्टैंडिंग ऑन देयर एंड। My Gandiva is slipping from my hand. My all skins are burning. Nacha shaknom yavasthatum brahmati vacha me manaha nimittani cha pashyami viparitani keshava. I am not able to stand. It seems to be my mind is deluded. I am getting greediness. This expression, this is not the Arjuna's expressions. First time in his life, he blabbers like that. It was very shocking for him to see the reactions, something, you know, the body reacts differently. That's what he is, because Krishna being a friend, he has only one solution there. Usually, you know, this body, we are affected because of the natural, some force maybe from outside. This body gets disease sometimes. But Arjuna was healthy. No problem at all. But why he is undergoing this kind of issues. Now Shastra very clearly says, I know the problem of Arjuna right now, what is going with him. Then this Shastra divides this body itself into three aspects. All the creatures, whoever or whatever that is manifested, it has got three aspects: causal level, subtle level, and gross level. And it also nicely expresses causal body, karana shariram, subtle body, sukshma shariram, gross body, sthula shariram. It means what? Every one of us, we have three aspects of the body. But the science means, the medical science, it has got its own method to diagnose the system which we have. Those they have MRI, CT scan, endoscopy, and even all the blood tests to test what kind of disease that body has caught by. But this Shastra is so subtle. Not only that, it goes, it penetrates deep into the conscious level. These divisions you can find only with our Sanatana Dharma. It's an excellent, spectacular view or aspects of approaching our Sharira. There it is said, the physical system can be affected by this subtle system, and this subtle and gross, physical means I mean gross. These both subtle and gross system can be affected by the causal system. So this is the setup that which we have. Now this physical body can undergo kind of a fever, a headache, stomach upset, or skin diseases, nervous system, headache, all those problems. Psychologically also we become depressed and we become angry. Sometimes we are afraid of something. Sometimes we are jealous. All those problems, it belongs to subtle system. This subtle system can cause illness of the gross body. That we know, it's very simple. But these both organs are connected. For example, if you are having the nature of angry bird, always to become angry, so much aggressive nature, and a warning irritative tendency, means always becoming irritated, then your liver will be spoiled. You can see some deficiency you can find with your liver. And certain people, you know, they have lots of fear. If you live with fear, fear is an emotion. If you allow your mind to endowed with fear, your urinary bladder will be collapsed. And it is all other way round too. If your urinal bladder is collapsed, means it has got some deficiency, your psychological system, you will be endowed with lots of fear, loaded with fear. If your liver is spoiled, then you will automatically have that irritative nature, and the angry bird, you will become angry bird. In the same way, this if your lungs are affected, it means you have sadness, that shoka. When you have lots of shoka, then your lungs will be affected. When lungs are affected, definitely large intestine, it will be affected. All this Ayurveda, the science of Indian medical system, it very clearly, Sushruta, Charaka, they have presented, they are displayed for us. They say, if you have fear, definitely your urinal bladder will be having problem. If you have problem with urinal bladder, you will be having fear. That the same thing happened here. Something went wrong with Arjuna. Therefore, what? He is getting all the problem physically now. Therefore, Ayurveda is the best, you know, suitable treatment for us. And all other, you know, other system also very effective, because human being, we have invented so many systems. I value every system, but we should not lose the belief, faith on our Ayurveda. It's excellent, because Shastra says, Oshadibhyonam annat purushaha sava yesha purusho narasamayaha. That's a gross body. That knowledge, if we have here, we can encounter what the problem Arjuna has. His psychological level is affected. Why it is affected? Because we also have three kinds of sources from which we can get the problems. Now Arjuna got the problems from his own system called Adhyatmika Dukkha. The Dukkha, your dukkha means a sorrow or problems or trouble which you attain or you get from your own system. Physical body has got its own diseases. And psychologically, what I said, all those diseases, the cause, if it is nothing but your system, it's called Adhyatmika Dukkha. Not only that, there are two more problems, means a source of problems, are said in our Shastra. If you get trouble and problem from surrounded beings, peoples, creatures, it is known as Adibhautika Dukkham. This Adibhautika Dukkham, it is little bit beyond your control. Then there is one more varieties of the source, like natural disasters. We call it hurricane, storms, earthquake, tsunami, volcano eruptions, flood, heavy rain. Sometimes, you know, because of the hot weather, global warming, all these problems are known as Adidaivikam. They are absolutely beyond, completely beyond our control. Therefore, we consider Daivikam means that is from the Almighty itself. Now, here Arjuna got, because no hurricane, no flood, no nothing, then what happened with him? This is Adhyatmika Dukkha. When you encounter the source of this problem where it is. Now, this, it is from his own system. Is it ill health? No, he is not ill health now. He was very, he might have had breakfast, you know, sound breakfast before going to the battle. His stomach was good, his physical system was good. Now, what went wrong with psychological level? That's what he says. Etat imam svajanam yujutsum samavasthitam svajanam drishtva. Oh Krishna, by seeing my own people, note the point, my own people instead of, or in the place of enemy, who are desirers for the battle. Mama gatrani sidanti, my body is losing the strength. My body loses the strength. My mouth goes dry. It had already gone dry. Sharire vepathuscha roma harushascha jayate me sharire. In my body, the body is trembling, shivering, and my all hairs are standing at the end of my body. My Gandiva Sramsate, my bow is slipping from my hand. My skins are burning. this my own people, though he could see, he could explain, he expresses the problem from physical system, but the real problem is with psychological system, that swajanam, the word. Those people, they are my own people. That's what meaning from these words. Then we'll go to next words. Nacha shaknomyavasthatum brahmati vacha me manaha nimittani cha pashyami viparitani keshava nacha shreyonu pashyami hatva svajanam ahave nakankshe vijayam krishna nacha rajyam sukhani cha. Krishna was very silent, just looking at him. He says, I am not able to stand. Aham avasthatum na shaknomi. Me manaha brahmativa. Me manaha, my mind is deluded. And viparita and keshava viparitani nimittani cha pashyami. I also could feel or see something which is bad omen. That's what mind is. When you are confused, then everything, it seems to be as though they are negative. Here, this, that attachment at my own people. Acharya, he says that mamatvam. That's what, you know, mamatvam works here a lot. I'm not able to stand, but I could see bad omens. I'm not even seeing anything good or greater things by killing our own people. And I don't desire this whole victory. And also, what is there with kingdom? I don't desire even kingdoms and all this sophisticated life. That I don't want. Now, actually Krishna was silently looking at him. He started and he was kept on moving and going on and down and down. Because being a friend, Krishna knows the strength and the weakness. And Krishna being almighty, he knows what is going on. Just he was observing. Now he could encounter that he is going to have a decision. That he is going to make a decision. That decision he wants to withdraw. This is the mentality which we have. And this situation also teaches us. Usually we live for our family and we live for others. Even society, in the society, all these moral books, even text, it prizes the person who lives for others. For example, a grihastha, a married person, he enjoys his life as living for his family. That's a joyful. Mother lives for children. But after marriage, 15 years, you know, so when children are grown enough to go to college, or children are got married, now there can be a situation when we used to think this is my children, means they are my children, he is my son, but the son will say, after marriage, after bringing all the children up, after them two got married, Because what? From the childhood, we were thinking, he is my son, he belongs to my family. But after his marriage, he will say, I am not your family. He may not say it, means, but it is understood. He will say he has got his own family. Now you will feel, okay, this is what the reality, chalo. But you may also attain a kind of situations when your own people become enemy to you. Then you think about that because you go for different places to earn money, you struggle a lot to bring money, to bring wealth, and to take care of them. You used to do a lot. Now they say that they become enemy. Then you are lost. Something went wrong. The same situation here for Arjuna. Therefore he says that I don't desire for kingdom. Because for whom I used to fight, I used to conquer many countries. After the victories, when I came back, whenever I used to come back, I enjoyed my victory with these own people. Then these people alone standing in front of me as the enemy means, oh, why should I fight? That nivritti, our mind has got the tendency, if it likes, it goes and it goes ahead to capture it. It is known as pravritti. If it doesn't like, it comes back. It withdraws from the object. For example, if you desire any object, you like to buy a house, you bought the house. Okay? There you lived the life and something went wrong with your own people. Now you started hating those houses. You want to get away from them. That's the tendency of the mind. Where there is a problem, the mind wants to withdraw. Where it feels sophisticated and happy, it wants to go further. Pravritti, nivritti, atmakaha, manaha. Pravritti, nivritti, atmakam, manaha. And Tattva Bodha says, sankalpa, vikalpatmakam, manaha. These technical terms from Shastra, you don't get into too much technical terms. You don't feel that, this is too much. No. So now and then I bring small technical terms, so that need to be introduced, because every technical terms are not mere words. They are technical terms because they have lots of meanings according to the context in Vedanta. So now he is going to make the decision to withdraw. Therefore he says that lakshya is gone here. I fought for these people. These people alone there as enemies, and I'm not going to fight. The decision he brings. Kim no rajyena govinda, kim bhogayir jivitena va, yesham arthe kankshitam naha, rajyam bhoga sukhani cha. This all logic of a family or a relationship is coming now. So what is the benefit and what is the phala, fruit or joyful things I can get out of this all kingdoms? And all this bhoga and all this jivanam is waste. These enjoyments, they are not eternal. He talks like a jnani, but he was not a jnani. Yesham arthe kankshitam naha, for whose sake I used to desire all these victories, and those people have become enemy. Then ta ime avasthita yuddhe pranam tektva dhanani cha. Those people alone standing in front of me as enemy, then I am hopeless, helpless, and even they are nothing but my own teachers, fathers, sons and grandsons, and great-great-great-grandfathers, paternal uncles, all in-laws, grands and children's, shalas, all these opposite relatives, sambandhinaha tatha. I have to read that words. Acharya pitarah putrah tathaiva cha pitamahah matula shvasurah pautrah shyala sambandhinah tatha etan nahantum icchami ghanatopi madhusudana api trailokya rajyasya hetoh kim numahi krute. Now, in these words, he has told what the decision that he is going to make. Etan sarvan hantum na icchami. I don't want to kill these people. If at all I am killed, it doesn't matter. You see? Even I won't fight, even if it is provided Trailokya Rajya, the power of this bohu, bhuvaha, suvaha, three lokas. No, I won't fight. So I want to withdraw it. That is the decision which was the wrong things to make. He made it. Krishna keeps quiet. You know, Krishna being almighty, he knows where to be began, because Arjuna has not finished him. When you make a decision, you are not confident enough, then what? We take all the logical and all the quotation from Shastra. The same thing will be done by Arjuna. Because when you want to escape from somewhere, you want to justify you. Now Arjuna wants to justify it. Slightly in his buddhi, he could have or he should have felt, so this is because of my weakness. This is not because of the clarity. This is because of deluded mind. Therefore, what he wants to add? He wants to add means he wants to bring the quotation from all the scriptures. That we will see from next class. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Oh.